स्टेनो वाले बाबू वेलकम्स यू। शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशंस इन मेल एंड फीमेल वॉइस फ्रॉम ऑल सोर्सेस लाइक मैगजीन्स, स्पीचेस एंड एडिटोरियल्स एट वेरियस स्पीड्स अप टू 120 WPM फॉर वेरियस डिपार्टमेंट्स लाइक SSC, DSSB, CRPF, दिल्ली पुलिस एक्सेट्रा। प्लीज लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल। थैंक यू।
एक्सरसाइज नंबर 17। इट गिव्स मी प्लेजर टू वेलकम यू टू दिस फर्स्ट जॉइंट सेशन ऑफ द 7th पार्लियामेंट। आई एक्सटेंड माय फेलिसिटेशंस टू द मेंबर्स ऑफ द न्यू लोकसभा। द 6th लोकसभा वॉज elected in March this year as such, but it could not last its full term and had to be dissolved less than halfway through. After its dissolution, the governance of the country had to be carried on for some months without a Lok Sabha. Happily, the uncertainty of these last few months has been resolved. The people of India have, through the democratic process, unambiguously rejected philosophies based on regional, linguistic, sectoral, or communal differences and have chosen to be governed by those who derive their mandate from all parts of the country and all sections of the population. The result of the elections has made it possible for the country to look forward to a period of stable government at the center. It is a matter of regret that today we do not have amongst us here representatives from a number of constituencies of some of the northeastern states. The problems of this region, and more specially the problem of Assam at the moment, require to be dealt with urgently and in a spirit of understanding and mutual accommodation on all sides. The government will spare no speedy solutions to these problems and to put an end to violence. Government appeals to all sections of the people to help in creating conditions conducive to this. Anti-national forces have become active on our borders, posing a fresh threat to our security. Communal and other divisive forces have also reared their ugly heads in different parts of the country, causing serious prejudice to our ideals of national integration and national unity. The confidence of linguistic and other minorities, Harijans, and weaker sections of society has been seriously eroded. Increase in crime and inadequacy of measures to detect and prevent crime have created a sense of insecurity in the minds of law-abiding people. Disrespect for law and widespread indiscipline have slowed down the wheels of productive endeavor. The economic situation which the present government has inherited in a matter of grave concern and anxiety. The last year has witnessed a vicious inflationary spiral, with prices registering a rise of about 20%. There has been a severe setback in agricultural production, while industrial production has remained stagnant. The massive and broad-based confidence reposed by the people in the new government reflects a keen desire that the deterioration in the law and order sector as well as in the economy should be halted and reversed. The government would like to assure the people that this is indeed what it proposes to do with determination and speed. The government will do its utmost to put down lawlessness and restore confidence amongst all people, especially those belonging to the weaker sections. The law enforcement agencies at the center and in the states will be activized so that problems are dealt with promptly and effectively. Honorable members, the new government has taken charge just over a week ago. The budget will be presented in the next session when the socio-economic measures proposed to be adopted in the furtherance of government's broad objectives will be spelled out. However, there are certain matters which require to be mentioned. The government would like to reaffirm its commitment to planning as an essential tool for engineering social and economic change. The great task of nation building will have to be resumed with redoubled vigor so that coming generations can hope for a fuller and better life. The government will devote immediate attention to restoring the economic health of the nation. Measures for the control of prices will be initiated. Stringent action will be taken against anti-social elements such as smugglers, hoarders, and black marketeers. The government is conscious of its duty to the weaker sections of the society. The new economic program, which had proved a boon to the poor, the landless, the artisans, handloom weavers, scheduled castes, scheduled tribes, and other socially backward sections, will be revitalized and implemented in a dynamic manner. The minimum needs program started during the fifth plan will once again be accorded high priority with special stress on education and health, agriculture and rural development with special emphasis on assistance to small and marginal farmers as well as agricultural laborers will receive the highest priority in the government's strategy. Immediate attention will be given to alleviate the distress caused by the widespread drought. All assistance will be extended to the farmers to achieve maximum production by ensuring proper and timely supply of inputs like fertilizers, credit, water, electricity, diesel, kerosene, etc. For this, the cooperation of the state governments will be secured in full measure. It will be the government's endeavor to ensure proper remunerative prices to the farmer for his produce, while providing for sustained growth of agriculture. The government will devote greater attention to the production of commodities such as oil seeds to eliminate our dependence on them. Thank you.